What's going on? Well, remember last week, in last week's episode, I told you that we were expecting snow, and here it is. Look at that. We got about, probably 4 inches down. Wasn't that much. It's a lot less than they were talking about with that crazy old cyclone bomb or whatever. We were supposed to get, what, 8 to 12 or something like that. Didn't pan out. This snow here came from an unexpected lake effect the day after, so what really got us was the cold and the wind. Woof, that was rough. But anyway, I just want to let you know that that pile, it's gone. It was right here. See where my finger's pointing? That stuff right there, that's where it was at. And it totally burned down by itself. I just had to come out one more time and rake it around. And but check out the yard now, that's snow covered. And what I'm doing today is I'm gonna jump up on the splitter and sort of try to clean this area up. Like I said, we're gonna do some organizing this year, and I want to show you what I'm doing up here, so here we go. All right, so all this stuff right here behind me is the area that I want to clean up. So you see all this right here, this stuff right here is ash, these rounds. I cut this ash tree down about three years ago, and then next to it over there is some pine that probably is also about 3 years old. So what I'm gonna do now is get these pots down. I'm gonna put them on that pallet right there, and I'll move them later with the bobcat. So my focus today is just to start cleaning this area up right here between the shop, which is right here, and that white fence. So let's get set up and get to moving, and a little bit of chopping, splitting. So I just dug out the splitter from the barn down there, and the tires are a little bit low. That's I noticed it because it was a little tough to wheel up over here. So I'm coming up the slight hill, and I'm gonna air up the tires just to get the rest of the way over here. But check this out. This Milwaukee air compressor, little compact inflator, right? This thing is so cool, you guys. It just takes the M12 battery, just put that in there, turn it on, and dial it up. I don't know what this thing, it might take 10, 12, whatever, I'll check and see, but dial it up. The hose is on here, you just screw it in, dial up the number you want, push play, and it stops when it reaches the number. I'll show you, check this stuff out. Wow, this one says max load 60. Seems like a lot for the little tire. Anyway, take it off, screw this on. So dial it up to 60, you just hold the plus, it'll skip by fives. 60, right there, push play. It's at 40 right now. There it is, 60 right there. It took, what, 2 minutes? So it shuts off right at 60. And I'm gonna do the other one, because that's low too. And when I'm done, this thing should roll a lot easier over there. This has 7 pounds of pressure in it right now. It's about to get 60. Hey. That only took a couple minutes. I didn't feel like getting the hose and the big compressor out. This little guy is so handy. Go get one of these. Put one of these in your truck or in your shop. the Milwaukee Compact Inflator. This thing is so cool, you guys. Yesterday I did my mother-in-law's car, four tires. They were all low, you know, because it's cold weather, and they were all just a little bit low. So I set this out, brought them up to 33 where they're supposed to be, and that little battery right here had enough power to do all four tires. This morning I did my truck. The fronts were a little low. It was, you know, the thing was ringing, the light was on. So it does big, heavy load E range tires that are in my truck, you know, the Ford series Super Duties. So this thing is great. It'll do these little tires all day long. Get one of these. This thing's awesome. And I'm not a sponsor, none of that stuff. Milwaukee doesn't even know I'm doing this. I just like Milwaukee stuff, made in USA stuff. I hope it's made in USA, Milwaukee. So I brought this up this way, pointing the way it is, because I'm gonna take the wood. Now these rounds are heavy, it's ash. This stuff is really heavy. What I should be doing is standing this thing up, you know, if I release it and stand it up, instead of picking them up. But I don't really feel like doing that. I don't feel like standing the thing up. I might have to if these things, if I can't lift them, that's what I'll do. But anyway, I'm gonna lift them here on this little black carry thing, whatever that is, and split them, because they're going to be stacked on the other side of the barn around the corner right there. So that's where the wood stove is, inside this barn. So after I split, it's going over there. All right, so check it out. There it is right there. That's all that ash. And if you guys saw when I did that close up, there were ants burrowed in there for the winter time. So there's ants, there were caterpillars in there. Typical stuff you find there. The stuff is pretty soft, pretty punky. So let's get to stacking. I'm gonna burn this first. So I decided to, while I'm sitting here stacking wood, I grabbed a bunch of that wood, see how dry it is, and I started a little fire right here in the shop. So I can come in here. It's not that cold out. I'm not cold at all because I'm moving around. It's, I don't know, it's still probably, what, in the 20s, maybe 20 degrees, I hope, 21. So it's not that bad compared to, you know, the 8 and 2 that we had a couple nights ago. This fire's warming up right now. I'm going to go out there and stack this wood up. And I'll take you with me. We'll stack it up together. All right, come on out. Well, unfortunately, the battery died, and you didn't see me stacking all this stuff. So, it's all done. It's all stacked up. Take a look. See what you think. Started down here. Ended up here, so it looks pretty good. I'm not doing this over here right now because over there is a bunch of old apple that's small log, small branch, that I want to burn that first. So, I don't want to fill that yet until I get that stuff out of the way. So, this stuff is old. This is that ash. Now I want to show you something. Whenever you're stacking wood after you split it, always find where the bark was. This stuff is so old, there's no bark left on this ash. So bark side up for me would have been this side right here. You always want to stack it on your racks when you're stacking bark side up. That way the rain, when it rains, the bark will protect it. It'll drop down onto the next one below it, bark side up, and it makes its way down. If you turn it this way and you're stacking the inside up, it's gonna absorb the rain. Don't do that. If you can, bark side up always. That way it dries properly and it's ready to use sooner. And it's just a better burn. So if you can, bark side up. Remember that, that's a dangerous pro tip, right? Let's go inside, check that fire out, see how it's doing, and we're gonna wrap this up. Right, so we're back inside here now, and this fire that I started earlier is starting to wind down. And man, it feels so nice and warm. I'm getting hungry, so I'll probably head up. I'm gonna let this die off. I'll close the doors, let it die off. I didn't set this up just to, you know, to warm up the shop today or anything, because I've been working outside. But basically, just because there's nothing like having a nice fire like this right here. I love this stuff. Having a nice fire and just being around it. It's burning. I come in here. If it's warm or if it's too cold, I'll warm my hands up, whatever. But it's just great having this in the shop to warm this place up. Listen to that. Sounds so nice. This ash here is burned so slow. Even though it's punky and nasty, kind of, you know, it's old and stuff. It's got some ants and stuff in there. It's still nice, such nice wood to burn. It's so hard, you know. Normally I'm mixing oak and oak and cherry, but it's nice to have some ash going in here mixed in the mix too. So split wood, you guys, if you have any way to do it. I don't care if you do it old school with the over the hand hatchet, right, or a maul or whatever, a splitter, whatever you're gonna do, or have one of these machines. I think I have a connection on something that's gonna be here at my shop in the yard here soon that might be very interesting for the channel here. So I'm trying to work this connection, and if it works out, it's gonna be great to see some videos on this. So more wood processing, never gonna have enough on hand. As you guys know, we are getting, if you've been paying attention to the right people and to the right source of information, we have some things coming at us, and you got to prepare yourselves. All right, be ready, be self-sufficient, be self-reliant. These things that are coming are, we're gonna have to go through them, and they're being put upon us by some evil people. So you just pay attention. Go check out that podcast I was telling you about earlier, Dangerous Info Podcast. You'll hear me on there. And keep watching these videos, all right? We're sharing you some dangerous info on here. Not dangerous for you, but dangerous for people who are trying to put you in certain positions. So stay dangerous, everybody. I hope you enjoyed this, and get out there and split wood. It's good for you. It brings you right back to earth, all right? Talk to you soon. Love you guys. Stay dangerous.